In looking to the future, this statement on behalf of Minority Rights Group will focus on three areas. First, ensuring full participation of minorities. Paragraph 53 of the draft recommendations calls for minority groups to actively participate in minority rights mechanisms. This can only happen with the full realization of Article 3.2 of the UNDM, which states that minorities should incur no disadvantage from exercising their rights. MRG is well aware of individuals who would like to participate in this forum, but who, for fear of reprisals, are prevented from doing so. We know of others who have faced threats and harassment upon return to their home country in previous years. The omission of any reference within the draft recommendations to protection for minority rights activists requires rectification. We also note that the draft recommendations are virtually silent with regard to minority women, despite the excellent outcomes from last year's forum. Many recommendations would be strengthened with members of minorities who face multiple discrimination in mind. Participation of minorities would also be enhanced by the establishment of a UN voluntary fund on minorities, and we would support initiatives to increase the number and quality of regional consultations and initiatives as well, building from the outcomes from this year's regional meetings. Second, the role of UN agencies. It is important this forum notes the challenges that remain 2 decades after the adoption of the Declaration, but also their shifting nature. The challenges we face today are not necessarily those we faced 2 decades ago. UN agencies and member states must therefore be flexible, well-coordinated, and inclusive. We reiterate our support for the new UN Network on Racial Discrimination and Protection of Minorities. Paragraph 56 calls for the new network to prepare guidance on minority issues for the UN system as a whole. We strongly recommend that this is done with the full consultation of and engagement with minority communities themselves, with particular involvement of members of minorities who suffer from multiple forms of discrimination, for example, along gender, sexual orientation, or caste lines. We also urge gender-balanced minority representation in the network itself. MRG believes that the network deserves greater visibility with its own website and information on its activities and points of contact. Third, strengthening the forum. In his video message yesterday, General Secretary Ban Ki-moon underscored that the measure of a nation is in its treatment of its minorities. We believe this forum can thus be measured too. We welcome the way in which it has been formed, providing an equal platform to minorities and states alike. MRG would like to see the forum further strengthened. We recommend that states here advocate for the granting of additional funds to the OHCHR to support their work on minority issues, and we commend the staff of the OHCHR for working under tight resource constraints. With regards to the suggestion to lengthening the forum, MRG suggests that we be innovative and flexible in this approach. We must fully consider additional options, such as securing an annual half-day or whole-day discussion within a regular session of the Human Rights Council. MRG will provide further comments in writing, but would like to add that we are continually inspired by the civil society actors working on minority issues we meet. We are inspired by the advances of the last 20 years, but call for continued high-level engagement in the decade to come. I thank you.